Welcome to the second hour of This Morning. Here are today's headlines for November 29th. Game company Wemade has filed an injunction against virtual asset exchanges Upbeat and Bithumb to nullify their decision to terminate the transaction of the game publisher's coin, Wemix. This comes as the Digital Asset Exchange Alliance, a trade group representing the two local exchanges, and three others, Coinone, Korbit, and Gopax, decided to stop the trading of Wemix from December 8th at 3 p.m. Wemade said it is also preparing to file an injunction against the other exchanges and vowed to take all possible measures to normalize the trading of its coins. A presidential aide has admitted it is realistically difficult to keep President Yoon Suk-yeol's pledge to reduce the top office's manpower by 30%. According to the National Assembly's stenographic records, the presidential secretary for administration, Yoon Jae-soon, stated during a parliamentary session on the 17th that it is extremely difficult to keep the promise as the public demand is so high and due to the heavy workload, implying that his office could hire more personnel. The top office has reduced 17% of its manpower to 409 since Yoon took office. Finally, parts of Korea saw heavy rainfall overnight of up to 70 millimeters per hour in central regions and along the south coast, while Jeju Island was under a heavy rain watch. Some regions will continue to see heavy rainfall in the morning. Most parts of Korea are expected to see temperatures drop below freezing after the rain stops today, which will continue until Friday. The Korean Meteorological Agency says it may issue cold wave warnings in multiple regions tomorrow. And you can listen to these headlines once again on our YouTube channel by searching TBS eFM. Once there, you'll also get a script of the headlines and subtitles as well. Coming up next, our weekly discussion segment, Social Puzzles.